to remember, though, that this event is also a fundraising event for the LUM Good Samaritan Program, our community's financial assistance program. There are donation envelopes at the entrance and at the end of each pew. Also, immediately following the program, which will start very soon, you're invited to a reception in the lower level of this building, sponsored by Lafayette Brewing Company. It's in Newman Hall on the lower level. Once again, to make it easier to see people coming in, if I could have everybody move to the center so we can fill every seat. And now, without further ado, let's begin.
Did you know more than 16% of the children in Tippecanoe County live in poverty? Households, mothers and fathers struggling to provide for their families. Where do they go for help? Lafayette Urban Ministry, through its innovative and effective programs, LUM has been giving help and giving hope to families in need for over 46 years.
The Lafayette Urban Ministry is an organization of 47 local church congregations. We serve as a social safety net for children and families in our community that are facing difficult times. Back in 1972, a group of seven local downtown churches came together to form the Lafayette Urban Ministry. Through the years, we've grown to the point where currently some 3,000 volunteers work together with those 47 churches to
families and children.
Now, won't you make an investment in the families and children of our community by giving to LUM? Just go to the LUM website and don't forget to find us on Facebook and Twitter. Lafayette Urban Ministry, giving help and giving hope.
Thank you.
Our host, Father Patrick Mycocas, the pastor of St. Thomas Aquinas, Bishop.
Thank you. I am really honored to welcome you to St. Thomas on this very special evening when we honor one of our own, son of St. Thomas. Our support for LUM goes back to its very initial stages, and we are proud to recognize that it has formed much of what we have done at St. Thomas ever since. I think that we are known as a place that cares deeply about our brothers and sisters, cares deeply about the admonition that we receive in the Gospel of Matthew to feed the hungry and clothe the naked, welcome the stranger. And Joe has been an inspiration to all of us at St. Thomas, and Joe, his wife as well, and how very grateful we are for your being part of this family. I'm going to introduce Bishop Timothy and his motto. Bishops have mottos. Do they all have mottos? I guess they would all have mottos. His is, the word of God cannot be chained. And I think that we would hopefully agree as well that the word of God and the acts of God cannot be changed. That our actions and what we do for one another as brothers and sisters cannot be stopped as long as we are inspired by our God who makes good things come from the most difficult and challenging of situations. So we do give great thanks this night and thank you for being part of this evening. In case you're wondering what 40K and 40 days is, we're not trying to raise money tonight, except for Joe and for LUM. We're doing something as well that we think is a way that we express our reality that what we do in the name of God cannot be restrained. We're asking our parishioners here, we began on Ash Wednesday, to ask one person a day for each day of 40 days of Lent, 5 words, can I pray for you today? And in that way, to touch the entire Purdue community. And we're well on our way to doing that, a way that we can be the face of Christ to the people in our community. So again, a warm welcome to you and a warm welcome to our Bishop Timothy. How honored we are again to be. He's here often, and we are always thrilled to have him here with us. And I'd like to introduce Father Bishop Timothy Doherty.
I must say that LUM makes all compassionate people and all believers look good, and I include myself in that. And I'm glad to ask in reflection of this history, which is deep and wide and persistent. Some of you may have seen Joe's farewell letter to his staff that came out in the mail. It was just a wonderful epistle that bears constant reference for all of us. I don't want to speak very long, except to say a little invocation and congratulations and best of luck to you. I know that luck plays a little part in our life, but prayer and belief and family love play a bigger part. So congratulations. We all benefit by your constancy among us. Dear God, please look upon us in this moment and help us to count in our presence the blessings of so many hearts and souls who look compassionately on the world around them without judgment, but with a willingness to help and to become light where there is darkness and hope where there is despair. We ask, dear Lord, that you infuse each of us here this evening in this celebration with a continued spirit of hope so that we can look upon all of our brothers and sisters as manifestations of you, dear God. And may we serve you and the people around us it with constancy and care. And we ask all of this grace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you so much, Bishop Doherty. Very honored to have you with us this evening. And now, without further ado, we want to welcome to our stage an ensemble of the world-famous Purdue University Glee Club.
was a police officer with the Lafayette Police Department. And when I first hired on, I was assigned to the downtown district. And in the downtown district was where there was the first residential area for the homeless, right there in the back of St. Marcus in the old nunnery. And I remember you had about, I don't know, Joe, what, nine beds, something like that. And it was such a desperate situation, the beds would fill quickly. And our homeless population back in those days had no option when it came to having a place to stay. So what they would do is they would get into fights. So police officers like Tony and I would respond, and the only place we could take them was to jail, because there was no place for them to go. And because of people like Joe Micon and his vision and his compassion, places now exist to where we can actually take care of those who are in need. And Joe has been. And Joe has spent at least the last 41 years doing just that, whether it be immigration, whether it be taxes, whether it be something that those that are not in a privileged position, or in any case, those who have just been overlooked, need help. Joe's hand is always sticking up. Joe, it's people like you that make this community such a great place to live, such a great place to work, and such a great place to call our home. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so very much. I have a little something for you from the city of West Lafayette. It's a little time. If you wouldn't come up, please. Scott Frankenberger does a lot of work with stuff that he cooks, and he makes it look beautiful. And Scott designed this for the city of West Lafayette, and I would be honored if you would take this.
I'm really afraid I'm going to knock this. you want to pull that off their problem so I don't break my own presentation before I have a chance to give it. So, Joe, what we have here for you is the Marquis de Lafayette, the highest award. Inspiration and wise counsel. Now, therefore, recognizing such selfless labors and vast achievements, I do hereby bestow the title of Marquis de Lafayette. Witness my hand in the seal of Lafayette, Indiana, this the 6th day of March in the year of our Lord, 2020. Congratulations.
That was the LUM Ecumenical Choir, which is made up of vocalists from many of the LUM member churches, who came together as a choir just for tonight's LUM Retirement Follies. Aren't they incredible? May be found in your program. If you haven't found a program yet, they're in the basket at the end of the pew. Just have someone pass them on down. Joining us also this evening are a few very talented musicians. Michael Kelsey on guitar, Leanna Atwell on piano, Jim Brown on vocals, Larry Gunter on drums, and Lisa Talley on organ. Give them a State Representative Gregory Porter, who represents the 96th District in Indianapolis and is the past chair of the Indiana Black Legislative Caucus and the current president of the National Black Caucus of State Legislatures, and also a past office mate of Representative Micon.
Good evening. I'm Gregory Porter, State Representative for Indianapolis. Joe, 41 years. You've been getting to retire after 41 years of being a servant leader in not only the Lafayette area, but throughout the state. Lafayette Urban Ministries had big shoes to fill, but I'm quite sure under your leadership and guidance, it will get done. As I reflect on our time together here in the General Assembly, it was a memorable one. Just kind of sat on the back row. We talked about the human infrastructure of our state. We talked about what you did in regards to the textbook tax on the middle class. We looked at addressing energy tax credits, teacher recruitment and retention, which is important, take care of the most vulnerable people in our community. That's certain leadership. And you know, Joe, as time goes on, even though you retire, you're not going to retire. That's not in your DNA. You continue to educate and motivate and be a change agent throughout these United States and the Lafayette community. I reminded of the scripture Romans 12, 7, and 8 that kind of moves to the point of if you're going to teach, teach. If it is serving, you'll serve. And I will even lay my own anecdotes to it. If you're going to love, you will love. And if you lead, you will lead. And you've done all of that. Your wife, Joe, has spent a lot of time doing other things with you and leading you to the people. And I want to thank her and her family for sharing you with us over the last 41 plus years in your unique ministry. Being a public servant is truly a ministry. And I congratulations to you, your family, and Godspeed.
And now I'd like to introduce you the infamous Black Voices of Inspiration, an ensemble of the Purdue Black Cultural Center. They would now like you to join them in singing Lift Every Voice and Sing, and it can be found in the last section of your program.
Hello, thank you so much for the introduction. We're gonna sing Lift Every Voice and Sing, as well as the second piece that we have. My soloist has to get back to work, so we apologize for making a change in the program.
Thank you.
Let's hear it again for the Black Voices of Information. Next up, another special message from Indianapolis, this time from the Associate Dean for Academic Affairs at the IU School of Social Work, Dr. Elizabeth Waller.
Thank you.
We would like you to join with us in singing two of Joe's favorite hymns, Immortal, Invisible, and Be Thou My Vision. They are in your booklet.
Thank you.
And now we have a special version of It Is Well With My Soul. This was a special song that Joe asked me to sing at camp one year, and it's always been special to me ever since then.
Thank you.
Let's hear it once again for the very talented LUM
State of Indiana, my good friend, Representative Sheila Clinker, and Representative Campbell, myself, and Joe, you know what, who this is really from? This is really also from the citizens, the millions of homeless, millions of people that you have made dignity in their lives and have affected them in a positive way and put a smile on their face, maybe for a short time, maybe for a long time. But this is for the people that you have affected also. This is what we call, as you know well, the Sagamore of the Wall Bash.
Thank you.
Chris Campbell and I all wanted Joe to have something from the House of Representatives that said 41 years of service, wonderful service, March 6, 2020, actually. And so, Joe, we just want to thank you. We're so happy that you ran for office and that you stayed for a while. We miss you and your expertise in knowing what people need, and there's no one who knows it better than you and your group. It's just incredible what you have done for the homeless and those people who need electricity bills and other things paid. Lafayette and Derrickman Street touches everybody's heart, really does. And I want Chris to be able to say hello to you too.
And it is, I'm so honored to be up here with you and my colleagues. And in case you were running low on things to put on your wall, I am so honored to give you one more thing to mark your years of service at LUM. We have done a resolution for you from the House of Representatives. Yes, and there was so much to put on there, and it's hard to read, but they filled it all in, and it is really my honor to be up here with you and to be able to present this to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Joe.
Thank you, Mike. You are awesome. How are you doing? That's amazing. Joe, we have a really special treat for you right here before we call you up. If you'd like to come up, these young ladies and gentlemen have a very special gift for you that they made themselves. The kids made this themselves, and it was put together by professional quilters, but all of these little things that are here is made of love from the kids at the after school program. And this is Christy Hope, and she is the after-school program director, and she does a magnificent job with these children, and they were wonderful tonight, and we thank you for being such a special part of such a special evening. God bless you. Now, without further ado, the person that you've been waiting to hear from all evening, the most incomparable person and the best boss that I probably ever worked with, maybe outside of gym, really. Please welcome Mr. Joe Micon.
Our state and indeed beyond. My good friend, my good friend, State Representative Chris Campbell, who currently sits in the seat I once held. I'm so very proud of the work that you have done and the difference that you are making. My forever good friend, Sheila Clinker, and Senator Ron Chalton. In these very divided partisan times, how fortunate it is that our community has such hardworking, dedicated, intelligent legislators representing us at the State House. They are always Purdue and Ivy Tech's biggest fans. They always put our community first, and they always work tirelessly for the betterment of our great state. And it is not an easy job, so I appreciate it. I notice I have several friends from Warren County, and I remember those years I hopped in my pickup truck going door to door running for county council, and I am honored that you're here tonight. LUM board members, past and present, thank you for allowing me to serve all these years, for encouraging me during those times I was maybe being too timid, for maybe pulling on the reins a little bit during those times when I was moving ahead too far or too fast. Our outstanding Lafayette Urban Ministry staff, how fortunate I have been to spend my days working together with you. I'll miss your good humor, our collaboration. I've always been inspired by you, and I will miss your boundless energy. Can we have a round of applause for this? To the pastors and the clergy of LUM member churches who are here, you have always been supportive and a friend to me. You volunteer, you serve on the LUM board, you've spoken highly of Lafayette Urban Ministry among your own congregations, as well as when you have been out and about in the community. Whenever I have called upon you, you have always said yes. And so thank you very much for honoring us, honoring me with your presence here tonight. The after school children, keep reading. It introduces you to the most fascinating people, and it takes you to the most wondrous places, and it makes you strong. And remember, balloons blow, so don't let them go. Eileen Weiss, Paolo Malavenda, thank you for organizing and directing this major, major undertaking. I don't even know what to think about all this. Our performers, the choir, Black Voices of Inspiration, Purdue Glee Club. What is with that song? Where did he go? Okay, thank you for sharing your talents tonight. Let's have a round of applause, please, for all of our performers. Percussion instructor. What an honor for you to be here. Jeffrey August. Where's Jeffrey? Maybe he's there. Raise your hand. Jeffrey did a solo this evening. Jeffrey was an intern last year, an Ivy Tech Human Services intern at Lafayette Urban Ministry. What a lot of people don't know about Jeffrey is his family immigrated from Haiti. And so he is now adding to our community mix. And Jeffrey, you have a wonderful, wonderful future in front of you. We're so glad that you're here with us. Ivy Tech can't even imagine how difficult it has been for her to keep up, not only with her professional life, but also with all the things going on in mine. She's not only been my wife, mother of our children, but my very, very best friend.
name is Katie Stewart, formerly Micon. This is my brother, Jonathan Micon. Growing up throughout the years, LUM has played a huge part in our lives. In addition to legislator and the upcoming elections, we are so very grateful for the memories and friendships that you have shared through the years, and that the rest of you have shared with us as well.
For my sister and I growing up, Dad was always just Dad. He was fun, energetic, exciting, always outgoing. But now that we're older, now that we're starting to see the world through adult eyes, I think we're really starting to appreciate everything that he's done for not only our family, but for the community as a whole. So without further ado, we've made this video in dedication, and I hope you all like it. Dad, we love you. Thank you very much.
Remember, this is a fundraising event for the LUM LUM Good Samaritan Program. And donation envelopes are available at your pew at each exit, and they will be available at the reception. Donations may be dropped off in any of the collection baskets as you exit the church, or you can just personally give it to me. Please join us now for a reception sponsored by Lafayette Brewing Company downstairs in Newman Hall. Our guest of honor, Joe Micon, and his family will be there, and there will be refreshments. Please note the Micon family requests that there be no receiving line. They encourage you to attend, enjoy yourself, and enjoy each other. Thank you.